let's get this thing started. Hello, welcome to the University of Idaho College of Law in our beautiful courtroom. My name is John Resovec. I'm the Master of Ceremonies this evening. As president of the Environmental Law Society, I'm proud to team up with our co-sponsors, Friends of the Clearwater, who's Environmental Sustainability Coalition, and the university's student chapter of the Wildlife Society. The Environmental Law Society takes a proactive role in increasing awareness and participation in environmental issues, influencing public policy, law, and jurisprudence, providing opportunities for environmental advocacy, improving the environmental policies at the university, and promoting environmental careers and practices. The topic of this evening's panel will be a potential delisting of grizzly bears from the Endangered Species Act. The event will be viewed through the lenses of policy, culture, science, and law. Specifically, we are interested in the implications of potential delisting of the greater Yellowstone population, and also what that might mean for the species on a larger scale, given their already broken up fragmented populations. Furthermore, we want to touch on any indications, impediments, and conjecture on the possible dispersal and natural recovery of the species into the more local starwood bitterroot area. The format this evening is for each of the panelists to speak for 15 minutes. After the initial lectures, the panelists will have an opportunity to question each other or respond and rebuttal anything that's brought up. Lastly, we will finish the evening by opening the floor to questions from the audience and answers by the panelists. So it's now my privilege to introduce our distinguished panelists. Panelists, please identify yourself when I begin your bio. Audience, please hold your applause until the end of the introduction. Please note the order these introductions will also serve as the order in which the panelists will speak this evening. Ms. Dana Johnson is a public interest attorney in Moscow with a practicing focus on federal environmental litigation, as well as general support services for nonprofit environmental groups and individual advocates throughout the Northern Rockies bioregion. Ms. Johnson has successfully challenged multiple logging projects for Endangered Species Act violations. In addition to her private practice, she is also a staff attorney with Wilderness Watch, and she serves on the board of directors for the Civil Liberties Defense Center, an Oregon-based civil rights firm, and Speak for Wolves, an Idaho-based wolf advocacy group. Dan has agreed to provide an overview of the Endangered Species Act and discuss how it applies to listed and unlisted populations of grizzly bears. Ms. Louisa Wilcox has advocated for preserving wild places and wildlife, including grizzly bears, for over 30 years. She has served as Senior Wildlife Advocate for the Natural Resources Defense Council, Grizzly Bear Project Director for the Sierra Club, and Program Director for the Greater Yellowstone Coalition. Ms. Wilcox also served as the Field Studies Director for the Teton Science School in Jackson, Wyoming, and as Senior Instructor for the National Outdoor Leadership School for a number of years. In 2014, she was given a Lifetime Achievement Award from Yale. Ms. Wilcox maintains the website grizzlyfinds.org, which is committed to taking action on behalf of grizzly bears and their habitat. Mr. Jim Hayden is a staff biologist with the Idaho Fish and Game, specifically with wolf, bear, and mountain lion. Mr. Hayden will be providing the state's policies on the delisting of the Yellowstone population of grizzly bears, as well as the impediments to reintroducing the bear to the settler bitterroot area, and other perspectives and information on the relevant issue surrounding his work with the species. Mr. Elliot Moffitt is filling in for Mr. Levi Holt, who could not attend today due to family health issues. We wish a speedy recovery to Mr. Holt's family. Mr. Moffitt is a Nez Perce tribal member who has served on tribal government as an executive committee officer, as a board member of the Natural Resources Subcommittee, as a chairman of the Nez Perce Tribal Forest Products Enterprises, a board member of the Intertribal Timber Consortium, and as a Columbia River Intertribal Fish Commissioner. Mr. Moffitt has worked with the Bureau of Indian Affairs, serving in high-level federal trust positions with NEPA, and as an environmental coordinator. His education includes a political science degree from the University of Washington and a certificate as a federal program technician paralegal from the American Indian Law Center. Currently, Mr. Moffitt is the appointed director of the Nez Perce Tribe Gaming Commission and chairman of Unibu Protecting the Environment, a tribal nonprofit 501c corporation. And lastly, but not least, retired professor Mr. James Peake. He taught wildlife management, large mammal ecology, and habitat ecology at the University of Idaho and the University of Minnesota. Mr. Peake participated in an evaluation of the British Columbia Grizzly Bear Management Program and was on the Idaho Grizzly Bear Committee that looked into restoring the species into the Salt Lake River. Please welcome our distinguished panelists.